Hi, my name is Michelle Embleton, and in this video, we are going to look at male fertility tests. How can you know if you are infertile? We're going to look at how are men tested for infertility. So about what physical examinations can be done, about the semen analysis, hormonal tests that can be done. And if you do receive a semen analysis result that shows that your sperm is abnormal, what further tests can be done to really identify the cause of the problem. Then we're going to have a look at some of the most frequently asked questions from our users and answer them for you. If you have been trying to conceive for a year now with regular unprotected sex and have not been successful, or 6 months if you are over the ages of 35 to 37, it is time to visit a fertility clinic to see if there are any underlying problems. When you visit a clinic, your specialist will start by asking a series of questions to build up a medical history and order a series of tests on both the man and the woman to check on the fertility. Specifically, the fertility tests involved in a male fertility study will include a physical examination to check overall health and of the reproductive organs, a semen analysis to check the quality and quantity of the sperm, and hormonal tests to check the levels of the male sex hormones. Not all tests will always be performed. It will depend on the particular issues presented by the male. And these tests are usually done to find out the cause of the infertility to best decide on the course of treatment. Some of the first tests that your fertility specialist will do is to have a look at your general health with a physical examination, in which they may perform a groin and abdominal examination, measure your height and weight, and have a look at your sexual reproductive organs. Your urologist will perform these to see if there are any problems with the testes or with ejaculation. They may even perform an ultrasound on your testes. If the cause of infertility is not found through these physical examinations, your doctor will proceed to the next step, which is a semen analysis. A semen analysis, or a sperm analysis, or a spermogram is often used to find out the cause of male infertility. In order for the semen analysis to be accurate, it is necessary that the man has a period of abstinence of 3 to 5 days before providing the sperm sample. The World Health Authority establishes the minimum values for a sperm sample to be considered normal. And from the results of the sperm analysis, if there are any alterations, we can then classify what exactly is the problem in the sperm. The first step in a semen analysis is to perform the macroscopic study. This means a study performed with the naked eye and not with a microscope. One of the first things they will look at is the appearance of the sperm sample. The semen should have a yellowish grey colour. Any alterations in the colour of the sperm may indicate an infection. The volume of the ejaculate is also studied. It's generally between 2 and 4 millilitres. However, this can depend on the level of abstinence performed and the day in question. Liquefaction of the sperm sample is something that should occur approximately 20 minutes after the sperm sample has been allowed to rest. The viscosity of the sample will also be studied if there's threads present in the sample, and the pH, which is a measure of the acidity or alkalinity, will also be studied. These are obviously things that the patient themselves may be aware of in their own semen sample. Then there is also the microscopic studied. Using microscopes in the laboratory, the following things are also looked at. The motility of the sperm is studied. So all the sperm need to be able to move forward progressively in order to be able to reach the egg for fertilization. It's important to look at how the sperms move. A sperm count is done. The concentration of the sperm present in the sample is also looked at in a special counting procedure. They will also look at the morphology of the sperm to make sure the head, the midsection, and the tail are properly formed. Sperm vitality is also looked at. Sometimes there are dead sperm present in the sperm sample, which will obviously not be able to fertilize an egg. There are any leukocytes visible under the microscope. These are white blood cells. It may be indicative that there is an infection present. The results of the macroscopic and microscopic study are put together to give you the report of your semen analysis. If you have had a semen analysis and the results come back as abnormal, your fertility specialist may order some hormonal tests. From a blood draw, they will then test the levels of the specific male sex hormones to see if there are any alterations present here. The production of sperm is tightly controlled by the male sex hormones, including testosterone, follicle-stimulating hormone, and luteinizing hormone. The interaction and the levels of these hormones directly affect sperm production, so it is important to study these. If you have had an abnormal semen analysis result back, your doctor may require you to have further testing. One of these could be a DNA sperm fragmentation test. In this, the DNA itself of your sperm is studied in genetic testing to see if the DNA is intact or if it is fragmenting, breaking up. Obviously, when the DNA is breaking up, it can cause issues in fertilization or in embryo development. In recent years, the percentage of men presenting DNA fragmentation in their sperm has increased, and these can be due to factors such as environmental toxins, poor lifestyle habits, smoking, drinking, and so on. Men who present a sperm DNA fragmentation rate of over 30% should be looking at assisted reproduction treatments to have children. If during a microscopic study of your semen, the specialist finds more than 1 million leukocytes, white blood cells, per milliliter of sample, it may be an indication that there is an infection present, in which case the sperm sample will be cultured under laboratory conditions. This is basically a way of growing the bacteria that is present in the sperm sample so we can identify any bacteria there and if there are any infections. If any infections are present, these can be gen treated to help aid the fertility in the future. A semen culture also may be ordered if the man has noted any pain, any swelling, any discoloration or an unusual smell to their semen. These can all indicate there may be an infection present, and so your specialist will order a semen culture. The karyotype is the set of chromosomes that there are in every cell of the human body. A human cell has 46 chromosomes, set up as 23 pairs of chromosomes. One of these pairs is the X and Y chromosome. In the karyotype study, the chromosomes are studied to see if there is any alteration in the number or structure of the chromosomes to see if there are any problems. To perform a karyotype study, your doctor will do this via a blood test. The karyotype study is an important fertility test and is generally carried out for the man and the woman in cases of infertility. In this test, the sperm will be placed into a special medium, a special liquid, and it's designed to look at the membranes of the sperm cells to check if they are viable and motile. If the sperm cells are in poor quality, poor condition, or perhaps dead, they will not swell. And therefore, we will know that they are not good sperm with good motility. Sperm fish stands for fluorescent in situ hybridization of the sperm. Basically, this is a way of using a genetic test to look at the chromosomes inside the sperm. This can show us if there are any chromosomes that are repeated or missing, which is vital to know the health of your sperm. These kinds of tests of fish are usually used if there are repeated cases of implantation failure or recurrent miscarriages, if there are known genetic disorders in the male, to look specifically for sperm that are healthy. It can also be useful in cases of advancing paternal age or if the man has had chemotherapy or radiotherapy treatment previously to ensure that any sperm used are genetically correct. Well, a testicular biopsy is a process by which a small sample of the testicular tissue is removed, and this is the area where the sperm production occurs. Your doctor may order this test if there is a case of azoospermia, basically a zero sperm count. By ordering this test, your doctor can find out if there is actually sperm production taking place. Usually, this doesn't present much discomfort to the male. Now we're going to have a look at a couple of the most frequently asked questions from our users. Does age affect male fertility? In men, sperm production is an ongoing process that will occur throughout their life from the onset of puberty. However, even though the male will continue to produce sperm all of his life, he may not produce the same quantity of sperm throughout his life or the same quality. So although age isn't such an important factor as it is in women, it still is a factor to consider in men. Between the ages of 40 and 70, there is a gradual decrease in testosterone production in the male body. As testosterone is important for sperm production, we can see a decline in the production of the quantity of sperm and the quality of sperm in terms of its morphology and its motility. What is the most important thing in male fertility testing? When a couple presents for fertility testing, one of the most important things to test for if looking for infertility in the male is in the semen analysis. This test consists of evaluating a semen sample to look if there are any alterations such as the volume, the smell, the colour, the texture. The sperm count will be performed to look at the concentration, to look at the motility of the sperm and the morphology of the sperm. If you receive a semen analysis report that shows alterations in your semen, you will be required to undergo the test again, usually about 3 months later. Sometimes you can present with abnormal semen qualities, which may be due to factors such as stress, a poor diet, smoking, alcohol. And so it is a good idea to repeat the test after 3 months to see if there's any improvement in the sperm quality. If after 3 months you give a second sperm sample and again the results come back abnormal, your specialist may then require further tests such as looking at your sperm DNA to see if there's any fragmentation or specific chromosomal alterations, to look if there is any infections, or they may indeed want to do a testicular biopsy to look at sperm production itself. We would like to hear about your experiences. If you have anything you'd like to share with us, please do leave a comment in the section below. We hope you have enjoyed this video, and if you have, please click like and subscribe so you don't miss any future videos. And I would like to remind you that, as always, we leave you with a link to an article in the description below where you can read more about the male infertility tests that you may be required to undergo. Thank you.